which I think is highlighted. Otherwise, the water sits there. It puddles in a couple of places, in particular at the top of that photograph, which makes me consider actually one or two of those semi-detached buildings will actually be sat on what looks like collapsed ground. Yeah, there are culprits originally ran all the way down, but I make no claims to it.
Okay.
But there is also running through the middle of that, there is a street underground. And that is shown up on the environmental plans.
Yeah. Thank you, Jeff. So, as I understand it, Kelvin is saying that there's water coming up out of the ground, and it's not just the rainfall that's affecting things. But the land does slow, the water runs off it.
Last year, it came over top of the floor.
I'm only allowed to allow council to ask a question.
It's okay.
He's just saying he needs to come back.
Chairman, a question for John, who says residents don't want development. This clearly is surrounded by housing and everything like that. Is there a similar argument, sorry John, is there a similar argument in terms of other applications that we've got in? I think we've got an application for 34 houses on the edge of North Hope, on Salford or Ely or Salford Road, Ely, depending which way you look at it. So is there a same argument there? Do residents not want those 34 houses?
Okay. If you ask me the question, you ask the question I don't know, but they haven't answered that. The next question I'd like to say to you in response to this property is that that lump of land isn't really, it's got a footpath across it, it doesn't need houses on, and nobody wants the houses there. And I would urge councillors to refuse this plan permission. I just see a third one and I feel it.
Sorry. Not allowed to. It's not my room, it's the council's room. I can't allow people to come back in for a second.
Thank you, Chairman. No.
Yeah. Any other speakers? Neil, you just want to respond to some of the questions that come from the council?
Sure. As mentioned about the amended plans, all the amended plans basically show was a piece of that was the only addition in there. The criticism of the area committed it didn't show the whole route from the side down here. Effects on the initial plan was shown there. That's all the criticisms. The other point was Councillor Whips right about the attenuation side. There is an oversized pipe shown onto the properties. It is on the plans, so there is a diagram showing what falls this in terms of the attenuation from the toward the water surface is when it's common practice if you look at the principles of drainage strategies and then you can you don't have to design everything to be there to do this. What's happened here is the information came through that particularly the local flood authority were not happy with not sufficient information, calculations, etc. We came back, more work was done on the drainage strategy, the local flood authority was fully responsible for the issues. Let's come back to say we're happy with that. The notice condition number 15, I think it is, related to drainage. That basically says the parameters of what should the site house be accepted by the authority. Final full design hasn't been done yet, that should come forward later on. But so that's approved by various bodies building on the storm. So that principle of what should come on site are established exactly as it is the design. It's controlled by saying the parameters of this are X, we have to do then later on to do it. So, if you recall, we got costs for not doing this at is a way of dealing with it, which is established on the structure.
Forever, Councillor. Condition 14 to why we can afford to have a table as we said. It
storage that has capacity given in the storage facilities, but the release is still recovered, so you do not get, when the land normally saturated, that will not be pulled back. That is what the national position to try and prevent exacerbations in the stream. So, and that's commonly accepted. This works properly, and I say, no reason to suggest it. It's wrong to suggest it would make it worse. It didn't all that works.
Chairman, can I just come up? The normal talk of tank being put off, hold the water. As per what happened on Sunday, where the bridge was brought up, the station failed.
The case is that it's anyway, is it? Not many vows are getting put in, not many papers are getting put in, otherwise he had been top of the list. So constantly to be a follow-up commitment. Any other agents have been right to have your mind and get your
Mr. Watson in regard to drainage and at this point earlier on about this foul connection to Aspen Grove, which has been questioned by Councillor Carroll as to whether the Aspen Grove sewers are able to take the additional foul sewage from any proposed development. Could I ask what the response of Yorkshire Water, as the foul sewage authority, put that way, is to the application? Because if their sewers can't take it, they're going to turn around and say, well, our foul sewers can't take it. So what are they saying? They're the people to say, will the sewers take it or will the sewers not take it? Sure. Sorry?
So, you're not going, but I'm going to anyway. How have they responded when you wanted to change that drawing today? How did they respond to that drawing when you wanted to change that drawing today?
John, I'll stop you now.
Thank you.
Due respect, all that's changed is that piece of evidence showed it was clear. Sorry. Absolutely crystal clear the intentions of the working graves. No ambiguity.
So, Chairman, just to clarify that point, Mr. Watson is saying Yorkshire Water, in submitting their comments, were aware that the connection would be to Aspen Road to help themselves with the applications. Thank you.
Okay. If I can pick up on in terms of the before I've gone to that, maybe a colleague looked at page 10 of the report, and I'll tell them that we've spoken on the briefs application at the last meeting. The government had tilted development quite clearly, whether developers fail or set them over anybody else, the briefs currently, as they set out, have tilted development, which hinders planning committees in this case. We sit as a body of the initial vote on this part of the policy resources committee. Likewise, in terms of my point here, page 11, it talks about the residential community and assessment plan, and I think the wording there is quite clear. From what I've picked up from councillors Goldthorpe and Carroll, the issue is drainage. If you look at conditions 12, 13 and 14 on page 18, my own view is that they quite clearly address that particular point of the drainage. I'm not in a position to support most people just purely on that particular ground, because conditions are quite good. There's nothing that happened at all on that site until the drainage issues have been put forward and agreed by the planning authority in this case. The code could even get it, well, I say we weren't built and actually get anything in terms of the ground. So I'm going to move the officer recommendations amendments because the conditions are quite good, I think, address some of the major concerns of guest my residents. Any other speakers? I'll take mine to the amendment, so that could be to take up questions of all. All those in favour of approving this application are set out in the office of the board of the All those against? Come to the amendment, which is from Councillor Coulthard and by Councillor Carroll, to refuse the application on the grounds of drainage. All those in favour of that motion? All those against? That's not passed as well. Nothing on the table at the moment.
Your vote.
Mr. Chairman, might you have your casting for like you have there?
Craig, you just found me on the second of legal advice.
You're welcome.
Eventually get
to this.
You're up.
Yeah.
You.
I'm going to bring item 9 forward, which is this is important because I have a number of speakers on that. I shall take them in the order that they are written. And I have them. Can I check if Jim Fitzpatrick turned up? So Emma Jane McDonald, have up to 5 minutes to address me.
Because I'm not
Pendle,
I have
to
see the streets clean. I speak again to ask you to not deal with a contract to district and management officers. Fighting has been abundant in recent years, and having enforcement officers agreed to staff to help address this. Dog family control is a big issue. The parish council has initiated a programme of highlighting deposits, literally, in the luminous pit. It's amazing how much funds there are when you consider it so prominently. However, the issue of 2 MPMs did result reduction for a short period afterwards, so it is having a positive effect. In the last meeting, the council has come up with some really good ideas to complement the scheme. Publicity, inform the public who these officers are, what they do, why they are doing it. Have a secret shopper to test that the officers are working within the rules. The legalities of it, washing the mix, i.e. do people have to give their full names? Can officers help? Education, make people more aware of the reasoning, the impact of littering, especially the environmental damage caused by cigarette butts. I genuinely believe people simply do not know how bad they are, and the good number would stop dropping them if they knew the facts. The figures show that progress has been made, but until everyone becomes responsible for their own littering, something needs to be there to stop the littering to light. I believe a mix of education and enforcement
Peter Smith.
In view of growing concerns globally about our environment, it is surely right that here in Pendle we should be contributing to a small but not insignificant part to help reversing the situation. After more than 4 years of collecting litter, manageable fly, and reporting possible identifiable fly on a weekly basis here in Pendle, Pickle for Pendle have gained considerable experience by dealing with the public, private landowners, waste services, and various councils. It has proven to be an education in itself. And although frustrating, a most satisfying one in so many ways for our members. We want and expect to live in an area to be proud of, healthy and pleasant to look at. In our opinion, and for your consideration, much more can be done. Education alone, while essential, is not enough. Engaging more with the public is a must, and enforcement is vital in supporting everyone's efforts, be they professional or voluntary. Also, a shift in policy practice with the district enforcement officers is necessary, as has been proposed by council. The main source of litter offences comes from drink and takeaway, in our parks, green spaces, and probably mostly from vehicles, cluttering our roads, car parks, laybys, and waterways, etc. We want to see the fixed penalty notices for these offences significantly increased. And then we will begin to see a more positive attitude among our residents.